Hello audience, today I'll be showing you how to make a Python a text adventure using Netbeans IDE. Now I'm using Bandicam trial, that's why the Bandicam is up there. Sooner or later I'll probably buy Bandicam for about 20 euro, I don't know how much it costs, and everything will be grand. So first of all, the function you're going to import is you're going to import random. This is not for this episode, this is just to have it done and dusted. Now, you guys can go on codesculpture.com, I think it is, and you can don't need the import random, so we're not going to focus on it right now. Now, you're going to, NetBeans IDE, you're going to open it, and you're going to open something else. What is it? You're going to leave NetBeans open, and that's it. So, well, like, Python idle works as well. Now, to install for NetBeans, you're just going to go into tools. One sec. Tools. Plugin. Settings, and then copy some line of like text I have in the description. It'll be like a link, it'll be the only link down there, so yeah, that should be the working link. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna put in our first line, which would be locations. Now I've already put in a lot of locations and I don't want to put them all in again, so here we go, we have all that done. So now we've got like a town. We got the town, which is city center. So basically what this is going to do is it's going to import a it's going to take a tuple, and the first digit, the left, is going to be marked as 0, and what it's going to be is it's going to say city center, and the next line is going to say you are in the middle of a large shopping center. Now the second one's a description, the first one is just the name. So the second one can be a lot more elaborate than I've made it. So you could have it like, this is where blah 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 happens and blah blah blah, and sometimes blah 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 happens. And it will react the same way to how this is acting now. So right now, this should just be doing nothing really. Basically that's all you have, that's all it should be doing. So now we're gonna make where you can go from there. So you can like, where, we'll do transitions actually, that's easier. Positions, and then equals, and then you're going to do curly brackets, not square, not parentheses. Now you're going to indent by 4, or else press tab, either way it works, and you're going to go town start. What this is going to do, it's going to tell you where you can go and how, like, where you can go from certain areas. So we're going to create a dictionary with then Aldi in it, and then with Walmart in it. Now you're going to put a comma at the end of that. You're going to go next line, you go to Aldi. You don't have to use Aldi, you can use your house or something, you can do like your road or something. Yeah, this is probably one of the easier ways. We're going to get into classes and stuff sooner or later anyway. The classes are very hard, and you're going to need NetBeans IDE for classes really. So I will tell you how to install NetBeans on the next video. Now, once you've when you install it, you're gonna have to get plugins and stuff from the link I put in the description. Just don't focus on that now. So there we go. This the next tutorial is gonna be completely different. It's gonna be a different part. So there we go. Now we've done that. We got all them working. And now from Town Start, you can get to Aldi and Walmart. And from Aldi, you can get to Town Start. And from Walmart, you can get to Town Start. So that's like, it would say Aldi. You're in Aldi. It says you have entered Aldi. And then it'll say you can go to the city center. And that's it. So after that, we're going to go down. And then we're going to do this. Location equals Town Start. Now, you can have as many locations as you want. Honestly, as many as you want. It's not going to affect you at all. At all. So now we're going to go while, T-R-U-E, next line. And in this line, we're going to go print. We're going to go print location. Location. And then we're going to put square brackets here, and inside the square brackets we're gonna put one, or else we could do 2 - 1, but it wouldn't make a difference anyway. And then we're gonna press enter, and we're gonna go 4 parentheses comma I, and then here T, then in enumerate, and then parentheses, then enumerate transitions to location, I think. Transitions, and then one sec. And then in here, you're going to put inside square brackets is location. There we go. Now that we've done that, we're just going to go next. I think that's how it's going to work. Then we're going to go print. It's going to be one. It's going to be, sorry, that's I. That's not supposed to be one. Sorry if I confused you there. It's going to be print I minus one, so I minus one, comma, space, T, with a zero. Now, we're going to put in, we're going to go enter, and we're going to go back to this line. We're going to go choice equals raw underscore input, and then put parentheses in with double things, and then go choose one. Now, choice, it's going to be int, followed by parentheses. So parentheses, and then we're gonna stop that, and we're gonna try running it now. You were in the middle of a wall. That's plus one. Sorry, plus one, and then we're gonna run it for a debug. And you were in the middle of a large shopping center. You can go to Aldi and Walmart, and nothing will happen, like at all. I can, but if I put A L or something like that, it will just crash. Completely crash. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go location equals transition. One sec, actually. So it's gonna be transitions. So from where you can go, two square brackets after each other, and then you're gonna put location. And then choice minus one. There you go. Now you have your simple text adventure. You can go to Aldi, and from Aldi you can go back to the city center. You can go to Walmart, and from Walmart you can go back to the city center. Now if you put a digit bigger, it will just say tuple index out of range. Yeah, that's just because you've put too much digits in. So now you can just add on and on and on until it's so big, and like, yeah. Now, to get, like, if you want it to get out of range like that, if you want to stop it, you can do this. If transitions is greater than, one sec, I would prefer, I think it's that way. I can't remember which way it is. I think it's that way. Or the old, I think. Anyway, we'll ignore that for now. Let's just hope people aren't idiots. And there we go. Now that should work. Now I still have a bit of time. So then you're gonna want to import random. Now you don't have to do this part. This part's like just random to be good, to be exact. So in tuples, you can do stuff like, I think you can actually run like the print command or something through it, but we're not going to go there now. Next, we're going to make a definition. I won't have enough time, so that's for next lesson, so we're just going to leave that there. And next lesson might be about classes, might be about, and you'll need init, you're going to need NetBeans. Anyway, guys, I'm new to YouTube. Please give me ratings, supports. I'm gonna teach you everything about a lot of languages, like HTML. I'll give you a lot of tutorials on that. I'll give you a lot of tutorials on Python. I'll give you a lot of tutorials on as many things as long as you ask. Anyway, bye. Peace.